Okay.
So we can see your slides. They're now full screen. The
Okay.
floor is yours, Falka.
Perfect. Thank you. So I will present our project about energy sufficiency and its role on the energy transition. It will be a junior research group starting on the 1st of May this year. And here you can see the core team. It's quite an interdisciplinary approach. So we are sociologists, economists, but also people from industrial engineering. And our main goal is to add a third pillar to the strategies of energy transition that are mainly dealt with so far. So renewables, replacing fossils, one strategy, and then using efficiency, the other one. But what is left out, usually, especially in the modeling, is sufficiency. So behavioral change that leads to an absolute reduction of demand. You're probably all aware of the IPCC scenarios for the 1.5 degree goal. And you see on the far right the scenario where they just took into account technical measures. And if you just use technical measures, it's a huge amount of negative emissions you need. Actually, it's 29 times the amount we emit every year at the moment worldwide. So at the other side of the scenarios is a scenario where social innovations are also taken into account. And due to that, an absolute reduction of demand. So there you don't need that crazy amount of negative emissions. And we think that's an important pillar, and it's time to take it also into the energy system modeling, because what is not in there is hardly seen by politicians and in policy advice. One important aspect is that we don't want to look at the individual who has to behave differently, but rather see it as political sufficiency. So which political measures can lead to more sufficiencies, that sufficient behavior is the more convenient one. Because as you can see now, behavioral change is much easier if all do it and not just a few have to due to moral reasons. So this is an overview of our research program, starting on the left for the areas of mobility, industry, consumption, food, and housing. We want to have a look at societal changes and to what qualitative and quantitative effects they lead in relation to energy demand. Then looking also at the sufficient policies that are already in place or that could be imagined, and looking at the chains of effects they can have. And then also the effects on energy demand, because whenever sufficiency or reduction of demand is included in energy scenarios, usually it's not made transparent which measures could lead to that. And we think that's quite dangerous, because then it looks like you don't have to do anything, it will just happen. We want to build a sufficient or program a sufficiency module, we would call it, where you can put in measures and get out quantitative, but maybe also the co-benefits, the quantitative energy needs and co-benefits. And this is, of course, should be open source and should have a good interface to many, all the different energy system models, you know, so that it can be used together. And on the group, then we will also want to do scenarios and kind of widen the space of possibilities of these scenarios, because not only including the technological measures, but also the behavioral aspects. And for that, we'll do scenarios in a participatory frame, participatory process, where also the framework data is included, and so that it's consistent scenarios. These scenarios we'll do together with our practice partners, because as you all know, we are already past black box models, hopefully. But we think it's not enough to go to open models, but we really need the version 3.0, we call it here, and do a shared development and scenario building. So really include the people who are potential users of the models afterwards at a very early stage. So it's a quite a transdisciplinary collaboration, also having some national but also regional policy people on board, but also companies and consumer advice council and stuff like that.
You've got 1 minute, Frauke.
Yeah, thanks. So we haven't officially started yet, but of course have put a lot of brain work already into it. And if you're interested in our research or have suggestions which energy system model to use, or even have experience in sufficiency modeling, or know about quantitative data on sufficiency measures and their impact, we are very happy to hear from you. So these other contacts of me and the co-leader of the group. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Frauke, and thank you for keeping time.
Okay, let's go back to the questions. I need to get my chat window back. Okay, any questions? No. Can I just say two things? I think that putting sufficiency in energy models is a fantastic step forward. And particularly, I think that modeling 3.0 with a much higher level of engagement in the model and scenario building is also fantastic. So I just want to not make a question, just make a statement.
Thanks.
I have a question about the participation of other parties. What kind of formats are you planning to get that kind of participation? Are you doing workshops or are you thinking of an online platform?
Yeah, so one part is the workshops to do the scenarios and also to get feedback on our modeling attempts and assumptions and so on. But there should also be an easy kind of or reduced version of the model, which you can at an early stage already, which you can try out online actually. And then we also do some case studies with some of our project partners, so where we have interviews and a more direct contact with them. So we know it's quite a challenge also with people who are not used to this kind of work, but yeah, so that's how we will try.
Thank you. There's one question from Johannes Hamp, I see.
Yes.
Okay, so hi, Johannes here. I was wondering about energy system modeling 4.0. So will you also be considering in the future contacting the people you're modeling and not only doing collaboration with the ones which will be using the models?
The people, could you give an example, the people we are modeling?
So you briefly mentioned that you might be doing rounds with probably consumers, as far as I understood. And when you're modeling consumer behavior and sufficiency in consumer behavior, it might also be really interesting to know to which extent you will be including these interviews.
Yeah, that's true. So probably in the case studies, that will partly we will that are kind of the deep dives into specific sufficiency measures and the effects, and there we will also use the methods of like interviews and really getting to the different persons.
If I may follow up, will you also be doing like joint scenario development with consumers and not only with
We haven't planned that yet. So far, it's just planned with the practice partners. But it's a very good point. So we have 5 years. So it's a good point. Thanks for that. Yeah.